الحمد لله تعالى. All praise and all glory is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Allah for the many favors that He has blessed us with, those that we receive and recognize, and those that we receive and do not recognize. Amongst the favors of Allah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us to be in the ummah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And amongst that, to be amongst the creation of mankind, the best of the creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And in this creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with iman, amongst those people whom are very fortunate to be the ones whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen, that will be given the opportunity to enter into the beautiful garden of Jannah. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored all of us with this opportunity and favor. Allah mentions in the Quran, He says, Ya yuhannasu taku rabbukum alladhi khalakakum. O mankind, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul. And created from that your mate, from which He had brought forth into the creation men and women as we see today in the world. Millions of human beings all over this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this, and this is the medium which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has used for this creation of mankind. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, He says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَأَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ. And He gives us in this ayat the warning and the care that we should take in relationship towards the womb that has brought us into existence. The womb that has brought us into existence, and show that there's a very serious connection between this for mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in the womb children that comes out for a family. So there we have brothers and sisters that share a womb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this womb in such a manner that He says that we should rever this womb, recognize the greatness of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created in relationship of the womb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this even in relationship towards His name Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahim, the merciful. Allah shows this connection of it because it's a very, very high status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised the woman. And it does not only look towards a mother, but it also looks towards our wives. A man, he treasures his children and he treasures his wealth. The Quran mentions, it says, Al-malu wal-banuna zinatul hayati dunya. Wealth and children, they are the beautification of this world. They are the things that we are proud about. These are the things we become happy about and we'll talk about and we'll look at with prestige and with honor. Because we look to gather these things. We look to multiply upon these things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look at what I have given to you from the womb. Because your wife is also someone that is very, very important in your life. But the connection, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, is that of brothers and sisters. A very important part of our life. A man, he can have anything or walk towards anything that he desires. If he wants a big house, he can build a big house. Once Allah provides him with the wealth and he chooses to build that, he can build that. He can choose which car he wants once he has the wealth. He can get that as well. Whatever he desires, he can purchase of these things. But he cannot choose and make the choice of who would be his brother or his sister. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed that for him by the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so it is that at times in one home, there are brothers and sisters who will be obeying the commands of Allah, and their brothers and sisters who disobey the commands of Allah from the same house. Or that comes out of the same womb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing to us what He can decree. And we have no control over this. But what is important for us to recognize from this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in this womb brothers and sisters for a reason. To recognize now the importance of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, He says to us, what is the importance of the relationship of a brother and a sister, or brothers and sisters? How important is this relationship? He mentions to us in the Quran, in the relationship of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He says, "An-nabiyu awla bil mu'minin." That the Prophet of Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is above everything else. Our own relationship, our blood relationship, our brothers and sisters relationship, our mother or father relationship, our relative relationship, our neighborly relationship, our relationship as brothers in humanity, our relationship as brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah says in the Quran, "An-nabiyu awla bil mu'minin." That his position is above everything else. That of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His position is as such. And that we should revere and understand the position of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That he is above and is deserving of our obedience. At the time this ayat of Quran came, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Medina with his companions. And we know the relationship between the Ansar and the Muhajirs that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned about their closeness and their bonding, that they would share in their wealth and in their properties and in whatever they had and possessed for the love and the strengthening of each other in that Medina. And even when one of them would pass away, they would even share of their inheritance. But when this ayat of Quran came, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after going through that difficult time in Makkah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the believers, the Muhajir and the Ansar, that whenever the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam requests something from you, you have to fulfill it. You have to fulfill the needs of him before anything else. That's why when the command came for jihad, and he requested of the wealth to form the armies to go for jihad, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, bring all of what he possessed. Umar radiallahu ta'ala an tried to compete with Abu Bakr. And every one of the companions of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would give. They would give because of this ayat of Quran. That above everything else, even our own families, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is deserving of such request must be fulfilled. And he says, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ. And his wives are also in a similar position, that we have to treat the wives of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with such honor and such dignity. And then he spoke about that relationship with the brothers and the sisters. وَالْأَرْحَامُ. And your blood kit and kin, they are next deserving of our true love and care and affection, that we ought to share with them and give to them, and then to any other person. Then to any other person. This is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the Quran for us. That the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes first, his wives, and our own brothers and our sisters. They are next in line to be taken care by us. And then our believing brothers and sisters in our community and anyone else as we see it fit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed this order in relation towards the ayats, in relationship towards mirath, inheritance. But from this we also recognize the importance in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to recognize how important it is for us to show the strength in the relationship between brothers and sisters. That we ought to treat them and recognize the position that Allah holds for that relationship that comes out of the womb. That we recognize that this is more deserving. That this relationship is more deserving to be maintained. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in showing this importance toward the sillat al-rahim, he says, "Man habba an yabsutu lahu fi rizqihi wa yansahu fi atharil falyusil rahimahu." He says, whoever is desirous and loves that his rizq, his sustenance be increased, and that his lifespan be extended, then let him maintain good relationship with his brothers and his sisters. Let him maintain good relationship with his brothers and his sisters. And two particular points were made here, a rizq. If he wants his sustenance to increase, the muhaddithin mentioned and said from this deduction is that it is the responsibility of the relationship of brothers and sisters that they ought to take care of their brothers and sisters financially. Once they're in a position to take care of them financially, then they must also look after the needs of their brothers and sisters financially. And he also mentions, and the deduction also says, as well, we should spend from our own time taking care of them by doing their khidmat and their service, looking after their needs. Taking from our own time to look after the needs of our brothers and our sisters. This is what the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to us. If we want to increase in our sustenance and we want to increase in our lifespan, then we ought to take care of our own brothers and sisters. Very, very important to the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us. He says to us in the next hadith, and a very important hadith, he says, "As-sadaqatu ala miskin sadaqatun." The charity that we give to a miskin or a poor is a sadaqah, it is a blessing. But wahiya ala dhirrahim, but if this was upon our own brothers and sisters, if we were to look after the needs of our own brothers and sisters, it comes now ithnatan sadaqatun wa sillatu rahim. It becomes double the rewards. One, we give sadaqah, we give charity, we give help and support towards our own brothers and sisters, and we also maintain the tie and the bond between our brothers and our sisters. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to tell us, that He's going to increase our rewards and grant us good rizq, increase in sustenance and extended life. Subhanallah. For that relationship, if it is maintained between brothers and sisters. Even the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions to us, he says, who is next in line to receive the reward as the father? Who is next in line to receive the reward as the father? And is that of the eldest son. For he has to take care of the needs of his siblings, of his younger brothers and sisters. It is his duty to look after them. And there is no distinction whether they are Muslims or not Muslims. But it's his duty to look after them, to see that their needs are fulfilled. And this is what the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying to us. How important it is for us to maintain such a relationship between our brothers and our sisters. And he also warns us, if we are not mindful of this, he also warns us in the Quran for our failure and our neglect to fulfill this responsibility towards our brothers and our sisters. He says, الَّذِينَ يَنْقُذُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِثَاقِهِ وَيَقْتَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَيُّوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He mentions in the ayat of Quran, when he says to Allah, mentions, he says, الَّذِينَ لَا يَسْتَيَغْرِبَ مَثَلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not ashamed to show examples or to give a similitude about this world and in relation towards the hereafter. And so many examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring forth in the Quran for us to recognize the truth. And he was giving this to the unbelievers to look at the Quran and read and explore and understand what the Quran is about. So many examples that have been brought forth for your understanding, so that you can realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sustaining you, Allah is providing for you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising you an everlasting life in Jannah. but they would pay no heed to this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of it mentions, He says, الَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ, as regarding those who would break the covenant of Allah. الَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ, who will break the covenant of Allah. مِنْ بَعْدِ مِثَاقِهِ, after they have understood it and they know it fully well. وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ, and they cut off what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained. They sever the relationship what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made. That relationship what is has established by Allah. We cannot change who our brothers and our sisters are. We cannot change that. And we cannot deny it. And Allah says about them, who يَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ بِهِ أَيُّ صَلَىٰ, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has joined you and brought you in such a family. وَيُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ, and you cause fitna on the face of this earth. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ, indeed those are the real losers. The losers fill dunya wal akhirah. They lose out the love and the bonding between their brothers and sisters in this life, and they lose out the reward and the thawab for maintaining the relationship between their brothers and sisters in the next life. So they lose in both the worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us and inviting us towards what is good, and He's also warning us of our failure to fulfill this responsibility. My dear respected brothers and sisters, in our community, and we are not talking about beyond the Muslim community, within our own Muslim community, we see so many cases of brothers and sisters in conflict over property. Over property. Or because someone of a relationship, because of one's wife or husband, that they sever their own brothers and sisters' relationship. Such a situation exists in our own communities of Muslims throughout this country. And they would live apart without maintaining ties. Years would pass, years would go. Their children, they will teach this to their children as well, to keep a separation. And they would devote themselves in ibadat and worship and do not recognize their evil and their wrong. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded, they go against that, but yet they are finding themselves thinking that they are in devotion to Allah, but yet they are breaking the commands of Allah by not maintaining the relationship and the bond of brothers and sisters. When they destroy this relationship, what a great harm that is being brought forth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala communicated to the womb in such a manner. He says, إِنَّ رَحْمُ سِجْنَةٌ مِنَ الرَّحْمَانِ, O womb, you are part of me. You are part of my way. And I recognize you. For call Allah Ta'ala, مَنْ صَلَقِي وَصَلْتُهُ مَنْ وَصَلَكْ, whoever joins and maintains that tie between brothers and sisters, وَصَلْتُهُ, I will maintain a relationship with him. وَمَنْ قَطَعَكْ, and whoever severs that, قَطَعْتُهُ, I will cut off my relationship with him. I will cut off my relationship with him. What a stern warning. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned what Allah is saying. What a condition to be in if we are not fearful enough of what Allah is saying to us, what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is warning us about. This connection that we strive to maintain with our Rabb, our sustainer, if we cannot even maintain that relationship between our brothers and our sisters, far less for that relationship between Allah Rabbul Izzah, our sustainer. We have to learn to live with our brothers and our sisters. We have to learn to fulfill our responsibilities towards them. If it is that we have been given the opportunity by our parents to say, I distribute the wealth, the land that is been given, I'll give it to the big son so you can share it amongst your brothers. So when the parents passed away, he keeps everything for himself. What a sad state. What a sad state if one of the brothers were to do like this. When the haq and the right was for him to do this job, it's an amanat upon him. But he did not fulfill that amanat. He keeps it for himself. What kind of account can he give before Allah on Yawm al-Qiyamah? What type of condition will be his position in the hereafter if he fails to fulfill his responsibility in even obeying what his parents has left? Far less for that which he is, which he has to fulfill towards his own brothers and sisters. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we have to take this opportunity to do what is right for our brothers and our sisters in this life. For as Allah says in the Quran, وَخْشَوْ يَوْمًا لَا تَجَزِي وَالِدُ عَنْ وَالِدِ. He says, fear for such a day, الْيَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ when لَا يَجْزِي وَالِدٌ. Not even the parents will be able to what? Do any sort of benefit to you on that day. On that day you're for yourself. That day your own brothers will go against you, your own sisters will go against you. If you want to do good for them, do good for them now. Understand their needs and desires. Make them happy and they will make you happy. If we understand the needs of each other now, definitely we will be pleasing our brothers and our sisters and they will be pleased with us. And they will know also what we are desirous of. And they will also try to fulfill that responsibility towards us. Because true love and a true affection towards one another, if it is established, then definitely we will live a happy life with our own siblings, our own brothers and sisters. And beyond that, we will be pleasing our Lord, Allah Rabbul Izzah. And beyond that, we will be extending our life. And beyond that, our sustenance and our rizq will also increase. Let us be careful and mindful of the rewards that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us for all these good things. And if we maintain a good relationship, inshallah, Allah Rabbul Izzah, His word and His promise is never broken and can never be broken. For Allah Rabbul Izzah indeed is our guide, our protector. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding and open up our hearts and give us the wisdom to practice upon His ayats and His verses, which are meant for our guidance and which are meant to protect us and save us and keep us all on the straight path. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.